إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم أما بعد إخواني وأخواتي في الله شباب إسماعيل أبو زكريا بومونت. And the topic of discussion that I'd like to discuss with you guys today is time wasting, or the importance of not wasting time. And in an attempt to deal with this tremendously important topic, I want to look at it from a slightly different angle. Instead of going through the common ayat and the common ahadith that most of us are already accustomed to as it relates to the importance of not wasting time, I'm going to try, inshallah ta'ala, to deal with this topic, like I said, from a different angle. Firstly, I want to touch upon the fact that our lives, as we know it, are a collection, or our life is a collection of choices. Our life is a collection of choices, and wasting time is absolutely no different. We all have the same 24 hours in a day. It's just that some of us used to use those hours in different ways. And in trying to understand, you know, what wasting time is, let's try and look at what it isn't. Because if we understand what wasting time isn't, then that will allow us to understand definitely what, or more correctly, what wasting time is. Wasting time isn't being positive. Wasting time isn't being productive. Wasting time isn't living meaningfully or living purposefully. Wasting time isn't being aware of the blessing of having time. And wasting time definitely isn't being in a constant state of remembrance, or maybe not a constant state, but a state of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most of the time. All of the aforementioned qualities, ikhwani wa akhawati fillah, namely being positive, being productive, living purposefully, being aware of your blessing, you know, being mindful and cognizant of being in a state of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these can be considered, or most of them anyway, as characteristics of highly successful people. And my research has led me to believe that highly successful people, and in some cases, highly influential people, have an unrelenting determination to succeed in any of their endeavors. Why? Because they really waste time. They're too busy trying to be the best that they can be. They're too busy trying to, you know, reach heights in their career, or whether it be their mission, such that they don't have time. Time is a luxury for them, such that, you know, they don't have any time to waste because it's a luxury. So they build mechanisms, ikhwani wa akhawati, around their lives or in their lives, that these mechanisms allow them to reduce the amount of time that they waste. These mechanisms enhance focus. These mechanisms that they build around their lives enhance determination and dedication. These mechanisms enhance their motivation, their ability to have a vision, their ability to remain committed, and their desire to simply do and be the best. So we too, in analyzing their attitudes and their characteristics towards their endeavors, we too should similarly build those similar mechanisms in our lives, in hope that these mechanisms will, inshallah ta'ala, in some way, shape or form, reduce the amount of time we waste. Now, I'm not going to sit here and say to you guys, don't waste any time, all right? Nor do I think it's wise to continue this, you know, lesson or advice without first defining what I think is the definition of wasting time. Because without context, the term is quite subjective. What I may deem to be a waste of time may be different to what you may deem to be a waste of time. So my definition, I've defined wasting time as not observing a balance, all right? Not observing a balance when indulging in actions that have no real consequence to our goals or our purpose. One more time, guys. wasting time, in my humble opinion, is the act of not observing a balance when somebody indulges in actions which have no real consequence or no real benefit to their goals or their purpose. But no matter what your definition of wasting time is, irrespective of what your definition is, we have to learn to build those mechanisms in place so we can reduce the amount of time we waste. Because every single human being in some way, shape or form wastes time. It's whether or not, number one, you've got the balance, and number two, whether that thing that that is considered to be a waste of time, is that enhancing your life in some way, shape or form? Because if it is enhancing your life in some way, shape or form, is that now considered to be a waste of time? And even if you do indulge in this quote unquote waste of time, as long as you've got the balance and as long as you're fulfilling your obligations and you're not foregoing and forgetting about and being heedless of your obligations and responsibilities at the expense of wasting time, then there's no problem in that. So I have defined my top four reasons that I believe are contributing factors to this lethargy. Number one, I believe that we waste time as human beings, ikhwani wa akhawati fillah, as a direct result of how we see ourselves. When an individual looks at themselves in a negative way, or not worthy of or deserving something, that in effect will affect that person's ability to live a more meaningful life. If a person feels that they're no good, that they're born to be no good, they don't have the ability to be any better than they are, all right, then this person is obviously going to look at his life as having little to no value. And we see this, guys, in our daily lives on a daily basis, especially with the youth. A lot of the youth, an issue that plagues the youth today is gang violence. Why do people get involved in gang violence? I mean, there's so many reasons why. But from them is that a lot of them don't see themselves as worthy of doing anything else. That's all they think they're good to be. People on the road, gang members. And as a result of not seeing yourself in a positive light and subsequently seeing yourself in a negative light, it causes you to act a certain way, to dress a certain way, to talk a certain way, to present yourself in a certain way, to allow that mindset to dictate what you do with your time. If you felt that you were a smart individual and you were somebody that had a lot of potential, you wouldn't waste all of that blessing or those blessings doing things that have absolutely no value or consequence or benefit to your goal, because you know better and you believe better and you think better. The second point that I want to touch upon is connected to the first one, that when somebody thinks negatively about themselves, that will affect their ability to live a more meaningful life. And that brings me on to point number two. When an individual doesn't believe in having a deeper, more meaningful purpose of their existence, then again, that is a recipe for a disaster. That is a recipe leading up to an individual wasting time. Why? Because they don't have a greater reason as to why they're existing. They are simply existing. We shouldn't just be existing, but we should try to exist with a purpose, exist with a meaning. We should be people that are accustomed to setting goals and having high, lofty goals and aspirations. And as a result of having these high, lofty goals and aspirations, we should try to strive for excellence and consistently do this in our daily lives in hope that this setting of high aspirations and striving for excellence will also, you know, by extension, reduce the amount of time that we waste. The next point I want to move on to, ikhwani wa akhawati fillah, is when an individual doesn't truly understand the blessing of having free time, then they are more liable to waste time. Because it's in the blessing of understanding having free time will make you avoid wasting time, because you will see it as a an asset, a gift that's been afforded to you, and it can be snatched away at any time. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said in a very, very clear manner, ni'matani maghbunun fihima kathiran min an-nasi, as-sihhatu wal faragh, aw kama qala an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Prophet said two blessings that many of the people incur a loss in. Two blessings that many of the people incur a loss in. Number one, as-sihhatu, they are health, wal faragh, and free time. Because you can do in your free time and also your health that which you can't do when you're busy or you're sick. And you can do in your free time that you utilize in the correct way that which you can't do when you waste time. We must reduce the amount of time that we choose to be in this state of ghafla. The word ghafla means heedlessness. And when somebody incurs a loss, as it relates to their health or as it relates to their free time, that person could be considered as living in a state of al-ghafla. And as I mentioned, ghafla means heedlessness. Al-ghafla leads to an-nisyan. Heedlessness, it leads to forgetfulness. And this, ikhwani wa akhawati fillah, make no mistake about it, is a choice. Why do I say it's a choice? Because when virtuous occasions arise in the around al-Islam, so like now, we're in the last 10 days of Ramadan, most of us are trying to consciously, all right, remember the blessing that we're in, and we're trying to get the most out of it. After the month of Ramadan finishes, straight away we're going to be in Shawwal. And most of us are going to try to fast the 6 days of Shawwal so as to try to obtain the tremendous rewards from doing so. We're consciously in a state of remembrance such that it affects our actions. However, when we allow ourselves to be in this state of al-ghafla, heedlessness, that then eventually leads to an-nisyan. And this is a choice. Just like we choose to focus in Ramadan or the last 10 nights of Ramadan or the first 6 days of Shawwal and the other virtuous occasions around the Islamic calendar. Similarly, being in a state of ghafla, allowing oneself to be overcome with nisyan, is also a choice. And most of us, with great regret, are comfortable in this state. Why? Because it doesn't require us to think. When you are in a state of ghafla, you don't have to think. When you're in a state of ghafla, you don't have to feel guilty about those things which you should or could be doing. When you're in a state of ghafla, you don't have to remember your responsibilities and your obligations no more. And it's when we're in this state of ghafla that we tend to leave off performing righteous actions that we should, or at the very least, we could be doing. We no longer want to hold ourselves accountable. And that is the raw, unadulterated truth. So the next question is, well, how can a person reduce the amount of time that they're in the state of al-ghafla? Because with ghafla has serious or come serious ramifications. The answer is simple. One of the ways that we can reduce the amount or the state, the amount of time we spend in this state of ghafla, is to try to, to the best of our ability, try to increase the amount of time we are or stroke remain in a state of dhikr of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the best ways to do this is by an individual being meticulous with his daily supplications. Everything you do, you keep the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala moist on your tongue. And being in a state of remembrance can be considered as the opposite of being heedless. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he mentioned and he struck a comparison between the one that remembers his Lord as being alive and the one that doesn't remember his Lord as being dead. وَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَذْكُرُ رَبَّهُ وَالَّذِي لَا يَذْكُرُ رَبَّهُ مَثَلُ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ. The similitude or the example of the one who remembers his Lord and the one who doesn't remember his Lord is that of the one that is living and the one that is dead. Why? This is because the one who is heedless, the one who is overcome by nisyan, is like the one that is dead. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was encouraging us to remain in a state of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to avoid this mental lethargy, because the two are not the same. The one that remembers and the one that doesn't remember, the two are not the same. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqulu fi surati Tahir, verse number 22. Allah says in surah Fatir. وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْأَحْيَاءِ وَالْأَمْوَاتِ وَلَا أَمْوَاتِ وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْأَحْيَاءِ وَلَا الْأَمْوَاتِ. The living are not like the dead. The living are not like the dead. They're two completely different things. The third point, Ikhwani, that I want to bring to your attention is looking towards the one, or should I say the fourth point? The fourth point. Looking towards the one you are disobeying and not the action that you're doing, whether the action be a sin or whether that be merely wasting time. As children, Ikhwani wa akhawati fillah, the biggest thing in our lives are adults. And then we start to become aware of things like huge buildings, vast areas of land, mountains, etc. And these things become huge. And then we become aware of space and the different galaxies. You know, there are untold amount of galaxies that exist and have been created. And then we start to realize, in fact, that we as a creation are quite insignificant in comparison to other things that have been created. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He clearly tells us in the Quran, as it relates to His kursi, in Ayatul Kursi, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 255, وَسِعْ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that His kursi extends over the heavens and the earth, and no fatigue overtakes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the preservation of the heavens and the earth. And He is Al-Ali, the All-High, or the Most High, Al-Azim, the Most Supreme. And if we think about this logically, the kursi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala isn't Allah's biggest creation. There are those things which has been created that we know about, which are bigger than the kursi, namely the arsh of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So if the kursi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends over the heavens and the earth, whilst no fatigue overtakes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then how much more magnificent and great is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than His kursi? Because His kursi was created by Him, and yet the kursi extends over the heavens and the earth. And we know that the galaxies and the heavens and the earth, from what we know of space, is vast. They're still discovering new galaxies and new stars, etc. So how much greater is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than all of this? Subhanallah wa bihamdi. So in trying to avoid the pitfall of wasting time and the ramifications of wasting time, look to the one whom you are disobeying and not necessarily look at the thing that you're doing. And inshallah ta'ala, this in hope will bring us back to where we need to be. So in conclusion, my message is simple. If we want to avoid or reduce the amount we're wasting time, we can do the following four things. Number one, change the way we start to think about ourselves. Number one, start to have positive affirmation. Start to have positive beliefs. Start to adopt a positive mindset. Number two, we need to start setting ourselves goals and objectives such that we can fulfill or feel like we're fulfilling a deeper purpose. And inshallah ta'ala, in doing that, we have to acknowledge the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. And acknowledging the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, which is point number three, will inshallah ta'ala minimize the amount of time we waste. And last but not least, ikhwani wa akhwati fillah, let's focus on the grandeur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the magnificence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not the act that we tend to find ourselves doing. And if we focus on that, inshallah ta'ala, these are going to be those mechanisms that allow us to live a more meaningful and a purposeful life, and inshallah ta'ala, reduce the amount of time that we waste. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته إلى يوم الدين. السلام عليكم.